Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I was inspired by the beach because, you know, I'd love to be there right now. So I'm doing kind of a beach inspired eye look. So I'm gonna start off this face look with my primer, and this is the Too Faced RX Hangover Primer. Then I'm gonna use my L'Oreal True Match Lumi Foundation. This is in the shade W4. I like this foundation because it doesn't dry completely matte, which is why it's called the Lumi Foundation. Gives kind of a luminous glow, but it gives great coverage. And right now I'm having some major breakouts, so it really covered all of that really well. I am using a little bit of my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer just to cover up a couple of blemishes in there. Then I'm going in with my brand new Naked Skin Weightless Concealer. This is in the shade Light Neutral, and you guys, I am obsessed with this concealer. This is definitely my new favorite concealer, and I was gonna do a small Ulta haul for you guys, and I might still do it because I did just get a few new products and this was one of them, and I'm obsessed. So then I'm going in with my Morphe, I think this is the G6 brush, I always forget the name of it, but it will blend out your concealer so seamlessly. And as you can see, the Naked Skin Concealer is super duper natural looking. I just love the finish. Then I'm going in with my NYX HD Studio Photogenic powder to set my under eye so that that concealer does not budge. Then I am going to use my L'Oreal Super Blendable powder in neutral to set the rest of my face. If I could talk today, that would be fantastic. Then using my Urban Decay, this is the Age Defying Primer Potion. I'm just going to prime my eyelids so that the eye look or eye makeup that we put on does not budge. I do like to go in and set it with a little bit of powder so that it really doesn't move. Then I was going in with my trusty Anastasia Brow Wiz pencil in the shade Ebony, and then I realized that I have none left. So, reason to go shopping. So instead, I used my BH Cosmetics eyebrow pencil, and this is in the shade Dark Brunette. And again, this is a brand new product that I am obsessed with. I feel like I am able to do my brows way fast. Now this is in fast forward, so I don't actually do them this quick. I wish I was this quick. But it really blends out seamlessly, and I really love it. I love it just as much as I love the Anastasia pencil. Then I'm going in to bronze up my face with this Physicians Formula. This is the Bronze Booster in Light to Medium, and I'm using my Real Techniques powder brush. I think this is the powder brush to just blend that all in on my face, kind of doing the C motion or the three motion on your face, hitting all the spots where the sun would naturally hit you just to give you that nice bronzy glow. Then using my BH Cosmetics Glamorous Blush Palette, I'm going in with this beautiful pinky purple shade. Now, this is super buildable. I always start out with just a little bit, and usually I end up adding on. I thought this was enough, but I end up adding on more at the end, but it's such a gorgeous color. I am setting my brows with the Anastasia Clear Waterproofing Gel. Then for my highlight, I am going in with Mary Luminizer by The Balm, and bam, this highlight is just to die for, and I'm using my Makeup Geek Stippling Brush. I will list the name of it below, but this is seriously my new obsession. I love this brush for placing your highlight. So then I just had a little dance break. I don't know why. I love highlight that much. Then just going over it with a nice big stippling brush to blend everything out. Then using my Makeup Geek Peach Smoothie eyeshadow, I am using that as my transition shade, and this is just going to help blend out all the colors that we are going to place on our eyes. Then I'm going in with Makeup Geek's Mocha eyeshadow, and this is just to help deepen and define the crease. And this is going to just give the eye look more dimension. And just a little plug, if you have not tried the Makeup Geek foiled eyeshadows, you have got to try them. They are thebalm.com. So then I'm just going to, of course, always go back and blend. We don't want any harsh lines. So then I'm going in with this beautiful, beautiful shimmery teal shade from my Morphe 35U palette. And can we just take a second to see this pigmentation? Ah, it's just gorgeous. So I'm just placing that on the lid. I am obsessed with these Morphe palettes. I have the matte palette and then I have the 35U palette. I think it's the 35C and the 35U. I really want to get the Jaclyn palette, but I'm trying to hold off. So then I'm going back into that same palette with this darker blue shade. I'm telling you, this just reminds me of the ocean. Does it not? Leave your comment below and let me know what you think about these colors together. Love, love, love this combination. So I'm just adding this to the outer part of my eye, the outer V of my eye, kind of sweeping it up into kind of a cat eye shape, and then going back in with my blending brush and blending over it so that everything just blends together beautifully. Then I'm using MAC's Shroom Eyeshadow as my brow bone highlight. I'm also going to use that as the inner corner highlight for this look. I just love all these shimmery shades. It just reminds me of summertime. And then I forgot to add the clip of the palette, but this is the same Morphe palette. I'm using the dark blue shade on the outer half of the bottom lower lash line and that teal shade on the inner half. So it's kind of a gradient finish on that lower lash line. It just kind of brings together that look. Then I'm going in with my Inglot 77 gel eyeliner. And if you can see, I do have a little bit of black shadow. This is Makeup Geeks. I can't remember the name of it. I'll list it below, but I put a little bit of that on the lower lash line. And for whatever reason, my camera had stopped working, so I missed the clip. So then I'm just winging out that Inglot liner just a little bit, nothing too crazy, but because the colors are so vibrant, I kind of wanted to just counteract it with this deep, dark black Inglot liner. And then just, of course, adding some mascara to your lashes. You definitely want to lengthen and thicken those lashes. And I'm using my L'Oreal Telescopic Mascara for my top lashes, and then the Rimmel Lash Accelerator for the bottom lashes. And I also missed this clip. Actually, I actually got mascara all over me. But I missed this clip, and I added some accent lashes. These are the Andrea Accent Lashes in number 305. Love these little accent lashes just for the cat eye effect again. Then, of course, I went back in and I added a little bit more blush. Then for lips, I'm using MAC's Rosy Rim Lip Liner, and I'm lining my lips and also filling them in with this shade. Then for lipstick or lip gloss, I'm going in with this new Lorac Alter Ego Lip Gloss, I believe is what it's called, and this is in the shade Girl Next Door. It is the perfect bubblegum pink color. I love it, and it's so glossy. Really gives that glossy lip effect. So this is the makeup look. Hope you guys like it, and now it's time for this crazy hair. So first I'm just going to take it out and just shake out my curls. I haven't washed my hair in a few days, so my curls are kind of nappy. I'm going in with this Redken Pillow Proof Dry Shampoo. This stuff smells so good, you guys, and that's just gonna help to refresh my hair and make it smell nice and good. And then I'm just gonna section off half of the hair and put it on top of my head, and then section off the bottom half into two sections. And then I'm just going to start picking up random pieces. And if you saw my how to refresh your curls video, I'll link that in the down bar below if you haven't seen it. It's the same process that I used in that video, except for I'm using a Hot Tools curling iron curling wand instead of my regular curling iron. Does the same exact thing. You might just get a little bit of a different curl pattern because it does go from thick to thin at the bottom, but I just kind of alternate the way I do my curls, and I'm just picking the pieces that seem really frizzy to me to help refresh my hair, because ain't nobody got time to be washing their hair every day, and I just want a quick kind of refresh and zhuzh up my hair. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm going to fast forward a little bit of this because I've just basically followed the same process the whole way around my hair. Now, once I'm done with this bottom half, I take a little bit of my BioSilk Silk Therapy, maybe not even a dime size, just a tiny bit, and put that over those fresh curls to give it some shine and make it look nice and fresh. Then I'm going to let down the top half, and I'm going to follow that same exact process. Pick up random pieces that seem frizzy just to kind of make it all look like almost like you've curled your hair all over, but you really haven't. You've just curled certain pieces, and then you can separate the curls, or just start to style it however you want once you've curled it all over. And you can always go back in once you're done and try to touch up any areas. This part is really up to you. Everyone likes their curls a little bit different. You can change the pattern of how you have your curls. You can pick certain curls so that it creates a certain shape. There's lots of different things you can do, but there's really no rhyme or reason to the way that I do it. I just do little pieces that seem frizzy to me, and it ends up looking nice and fresh, like I just fixed my hair and took a lot of time and it really only took a few minutes. So I love the effect that this gives, and I do love the wand. You don't have to have a wand. You can use a regular curling iron to do the same thing. Then I'm just putting a little bit of that bio silk again all over those fresh curls. And yes, it kind of looks like a lion mane, but that's kind of the beauty of having curly hair, is that the bigger and the crazier that it is, the better that it looks. So just trying to smooth out a little bit of the top portion to just bring it all together and make it look a little more polished. And then I'm using a little bit of Chi hairspray to set everything in place. I will have everything linked in the down bar below, or not linked, but listed in the down bar below. I hope you guys enjoyed this hair look and this makeup look. Please leave me your comments, subscribe to my channel, follow me on my other social sites, and I love you so much, and I'll see you in my next video. Love you guys. Peace out.